When I was a kid, I asked my parents if they could buy me Grand Theft Auto and they said no. They didn't believe a child should be hanging out at strip joints and murdering unarmed civilians. Well, at least not until they turn 11. I then spotted another game on the shelf called The Simpsons Hit and Run. We purchased it, but I had no idea we were buying one of the most legendary games of all time. I spawn in at the classic Simpsons house, and my loving wife Marge wants to have a cool word. I proceed to kick her repetitively. Abusive relationships are funny when they're animated and colourful. I flee the scene, and as I drive through the streets of Springfield, the nostalgia is almost overwhelming. I then pull up at the retirement castle to visit Homer's father, Abe. I proceed to also kick him repetitively, which I assure you has no metaphorical parallels to the relationship I share with my actual father. It seems I pushed society's social constructs a little too far, as the cops are now after me. I'm pretty sure this is exactly what I did the very first time I played the game. Glad to see I've matured and grown as a person. Marge asks if I can go down to the Quickie Mart and buy some groceries for our first mission. These are the cute early fun objectives, but the game really escalates. I'm not joking, later on we have to convert our own friends and family into radical extremists who explode themselves to save the town. That actually happens, but I digress. I grab the ice cream, return home to Marge, and just like that, husband of the year. I also drop Lisa her science project and brutally kill a child in an unfortunate vehicular manslaughter incident. I decide to pause the dad life grind for a moment and snoop around Ned Flanders' yard. He seems to be keeping his children in a dark underground bunker.
We only come out to go to church.
Christians are so quirky. There is also a mysterious wasp camera, which is our first big hint that the plot is going to thicken. For now, it's time to get to work, as Homer is a nuclear safety inspector at the power plant, and I have an evaluation today. Now, when you're being evaluated at work, you have two options. You can either put your best foot forward and strive for perfection, or buy a large truck from your alcoholic friend and run your boss's executive assistant off the road. Naturally, we go with the latter. I head to work, but I can't help but notice I'm the only one without a hazmat suit. On top of that, there's no seat at my workstation, and cameras are absolutely everywhere. I guess this is what it's like to work at an Amazon warehouse, except less piss bottles. I go around and destroy all the camera's generators via a cute little platforming section, and then head home to relax.
That black van is spying on us.
Oh, homie, you're so sexy when you're paranoid.
There's a seedy black van spying on our home, which is a monumental breach of my family's privacy, and Marge is trying to get frisky. How vulgar. I wish more women wanted to talk about feelings and periods, and not always just go straight to physical relations. I chase the black van to Mr. Burns' house and accuse him of spying on us, but he's like, nah, not me, mate, and that's level 1 complete. We then get transported to a new map and are now Bart Simpson. I immediately climb the Jebediah Springfield statue and kick the dodgy Malacca's head right off. I don't know why my brain retained this information, but for whatever reason, I remembered you could do this. God forbid I retain my girlfriend's birthday or the fact babies can't breathe underwater. No, I retain the fact that Jeb's head can be decapitated. Most of Bart's missions revolve around getting a copy of this new Brainstorm video game that is sold out and his parents don't want him to play. A hugely relatable story arc for a young modest pelican who tried to secure a copy of Grand Theft Auto Vice City. Don't worry, I won't keep speaking about my abusive childhood. I'll save that for when I inevitably get caught up in some internet drama controversy and I need to apologize but also make everyone feel sorry for me. It'll just be me sighing, crying, and speaking about how my bitch of a mother didn't buy me Vice City. Kearney, a local degenerate, tells me that I shouldn't even be worried about games and that I should be buying fireworks instead. I drive down to Moe's Tavern and ask him for some.
I can't serve booze to a minor, it ain't right.
I'm here to buy fireworks.
Oh, hell yeah.
I then remember that every one of these levels has a secret vehicle. For this one, it's a monorail cart from the famous monorail episode. You love to see it. I continue Bart's fun-filled family adventure of helping criminals, humble farm folk, and a psychotic doctor whose monkeys have run away.
Why won't they come back to you?
Because I have tortured them horribly, silly.
Say what you will about Dr. Nick experimenting on animals, you can't put a price on cocoa butter shampoo that doesn't sting your eyes. All of a sudden, Bart is abducted by aliens. This is where The Simpsons Hit and Run goes from a humble domestic violence simulator to a full-blown extraterrestrial invasion. Level 3, and we now play as little Lisa, who is concerned that Bart has been missing for quite a while, but doesn't know about the abduction. She also gets a Malibu Stacy sports car for her unique vehicle, which is actually quite fast. This is also one of my favourite levels in the game, and it's because it features pelicans. They may be low-poly, but they're still drippy as heck. I head to the comic book store to gather intel on Bart, but first decide to drop stacks on a new outfit for Lisa. She is now dressed as a mattress, which is both unflattering and protective, so she'll hopefully now be safe from all the Minecraft YouTubers. A comic book guy asks us to help him race a nerd to a limited edition comic book sale. We win the race easily by taking a shortcut through a large electronic image of Mr. Burns as a merman. Is there anything more arousing? I change Lisa's outfit to something more aesthetic, so I guess she'll just have to take her chances. In the comic book store is my favourite character, Otto. Look at him just racing that bus around by himself over and over again. Weed really is magical. I head to the Springfield Observatory, and Professor Frink tells me Bart has been abducted by aliens. Apparently, the aliens are using black sedans, so we borrow Otto's actual school bus and destroy them all. Everyone thought Lisa was a goody two-shoes, but this jazz bitch is out here murdering fools. I help the good people of Springfield with various tasks until finally I find Bart. He's not doing too great, but that doesn't matter as we've now reached level 4 and get to play as Marge. She's pretty concerned that Bart can't speak properly, but she's also an absolute baddie. I had the biggest thing for Marge when I was a kid. Her and Mrs. Incredible really stole my young heart. That being said, her running technique needs a lot of work. I head around the back of the Simpsons house and climb up into Bart's bedroom. Here is where you can buy clothes for Marge, and I proceed to buy the prison outfit for that low poly thickness. If you're going to be looking at an ass for hours straight, it might as well be thick. That might be the wisest thing I've ever said. I continue to try and help Bart via mostly elaborate driving missions. First I chase Cletus around town, and then I chase other people around town with Cletus. A surprisingly large amount of this game's missions revolve around Cletus. Marge and her dump truck have bigger fish to fry, however, i.e. the whole abduction fiasco. I get a tip off that a seedy black sedan is parked outside the school and is allegedly trying to lure kids over to the car. The scary thing is, Springfield Elementary isn't a Catholic school. Something's up. I hop into a car with Lisa, but it turns out the sedan was just a drug dealer selling narcotics to the children. There's no need to panic, false alarm. In fact, we collect some of the pills and deliver them to Grandpa Simpson. Mission: help your in-laws abuse pharmaceuticals complete. This is where shit gets really crazy. Abe tells us about mysterious crop circles that are in the shape of the Buzz Collar symbol. I rush home to pump Bart full of Buzz Collar to see if that helps, as there's nothing more precious than human life. Bart comes clean and says the aliens have poisoned the Buzz Collar and are encouraging residents to drink up to make them go crazy. More importantly, dat ass. It's now time for level 5, which brings with it one of the biggest plot twists the world's ever seen. You play as Apu. So unexpected, but he's a good lad. Anyway, Apu's pretty keen to stop the alien invasion, so he immediately starts stealing crates from Buzz Collar trucks. I was genuinely surprised we weren't stealing Buzz Collar crates from Cletus. This level's secret vehicle is also probably the best. A massive monster truck, which is perfect for Apu as he can compensate for his stereotypical tiny Indian Sorry, my microphone cut out. I was going to say Indian palak paneer, which is a spinach curry garnished with fresh cheeses. You can tell this game was made in 2003 and not in 2020 because the next mission has us dress up as an American so the police won't be suspicious. This is the real cultural appropriation though, wow, cancelled. Through our valiant efforts, we discover the Buzz Collar is being made at the museum. A cute old school scene that shows the evil aliens have turned Springfield into a giant reality TV show and they're broadcasting it to their alien home. They're using the Buzz Collar to make everyone go crazy and boost ratings. Level 6 and we're Bart again on a mission to get revenge. The aliens have set up laser gun stalls so the humans start shooting each other to further boost their ratings. This mission is called Set to Kill and is notoriously known as the hardest mission in the game. Back as a kid, I wish I was worried about conscription or child slave labor because this mission was actually terrifying. You had 1 minute and 40 seconds to destroy 25 laser gun stalls. A difficult task, sure, but it wasn't what you were really scared of. Once you've destroyed the laser gun stalls, you have 50 seconds to make it back to Krusty Studios. Even now, I struggled a bit with this mission. It took me like 7 times, but as a kid, oh my god, this shit haunted me. There's still Reddit threads talking about how hard this mission is. It's broken up families and taken many lives. I finished with 3 seconds left, and it was the happiest moment of my life. Despite my best efforts, the Buzz Collar is in the water system, which means Springfield is cooked. This brings us to the final level, and the locals have all lost their minds and turned into monsters. Witches fly along on broomsticks, but they're happy to pick up hitchhikers, so I'm not mad. This witch is getting sideways on her broomstick, what a mad lass. This game is actually legendary. Now, in the words of 50% of politicians, we must defeat the alien immigrants. Professor Frink shows me that if we take nuclear waste and then get sucked up by the UFO ray, we can damage it. Remember when I said this game lets you convert your friends and family into radical extremists? Well, it's happening. First, I convince Bart to go up in his Ferrari. It seems like there was plenty of time for him to jump free and survive, but then he wouldn't get to play Dungeons & Dragons with 40 virgins, I guess. Second, I convinced Snake to go up in the ray. Damn, The Simpsons Hit and Run really was doing ISIS before it was cool. Lastly, Grandpa Simpson goes up, but this time it doesn't matter that he's laying down his life as he's elderly. If we've all learned anything from this pandemic, it's that old people don't matter. The aliens are defeated, and that's the end. I actually played the entire thing for this video. It was so nostalgic and truly a legendary game. I'm also giving out a bunch of merch. I'm going to give it out randomly to people who are following my Twitter, so make sure you're following Modest Pelican. It's the only really way I can do it, so I can direct message you and get your address for postage. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.